The Director of Police Health Services, Dr. Moses Byaruhanga, says police is still stranded with 7 of the 21 bodies that were recovered following the collapse of the Chitezi landfill on Saturday. Byaruhanga said that the claimants of the deceased persons were handed the remains of their loved ones. He, however, noted with concern that since President Yoweri Museveni issued a directive for State House to give 5 million shillings to the family of each person who died, some unscrupulous people are falsely claiming bodies at the mortuary. It was a somber mood at the mortuary this morning as people claimed the remains of their loved ones. Those who could not afford a vehicle for transport adopted other means to take the remains of their loved ones. Among those who perished in this tragedy were Ronald Were, a senior 6th student whose body is still missing, as well as his sibling Raymond Chakonye, whose body was identified at the mortuary this morning, and both were students of Kolo Secondary School. Special Force Command Deputy Commander Brigadier General Asaf Nyakikuru advised the newly promoted army officers to double their commitment and effort towards service because the Uganda People's Defense Forces expects more from them. Nyakikuru, who is also the commander of Special Force Group 2, made the remarks at the 10th Marine Battalion headquarters in Entebbe while presiding over the peeping and decoration ceremony of the newly promoted army officers. He appealed to the officers who have not been promoted to wait on God's timing.
God promotes when his timing is right, not our own being human, not our own timing. So those of us that have not been promoted, please let's wait upon the timing of God, for it is always the right timing.
He also challenges the officers that they have a huge responsibility ahead of them and they would ensure that they are up to the task as they fulfill their mandate.
UPDF expects a lot from you. The reason it has promoted you. There is a huge responsibility, like many have said, right ahead of you. This promotion, therefore, should give you the confidence and authority to be up to the task, like many have said. Betty said it here, Wilson said it here. It's not just a decoration, but it's a sign of responsibility that is always ahead of us whether we get promoted.
Command of Special Force Group 3, Colonel Wilson Bagonza, thanked the President and the Commander-in-Chief of UPDF for his visionary stewardship that has transformed the Army from a ragtag to now a formidable force that is now exporting peace and is admired regionally.
I find a second, I want to thank the Commander-in-Chief to add my voice on Colonel Betty. Indeed, his visionary stewardship has transformed us, transformed the UPDF, and us as a whole. From a ragtag force we were, to now a fully formidable force admired regionally.
The function was attended by group commanders, brigade commanders, directors, commanding officers, commandants, members of staff, and command of SFC. Senior and junior officers, including the spouses of the newly promoted officers. The Electoral Commission has embarked on a program to engage young people in institutions of learning, in electoral processes, democracy, and fighting election violence. Young people are also called upon to say no to voter bribery by greedy politicians. Over the weekend, Electoral Commission Chairperson Simon Byabakama visited Naumali High School, where he lectured students on electoral reforms. Byabakama urged the youth to stay away from the violence and highlighted their vulnerability and manipulation by individuals who incite violence for personal gain while avoiding direct involvement. He also cautioned the youth against the misuse of social media and urged them to harness their online presence for educational purposes like research, business, and innovations. Mary Naula, a student, said that despite the presence of the youth in political roles, the experience varies across parties. She said they should all be given a chance to exercise their rights without being labeled enemies of the country.
My question is, what is the commission's mandate? What power does it have to ensure fair elections?
Byabakama's call to action seeks to empower the youth to play a constructive role in shaping Uganda's future, promote peace, and ensure democratic processes are upheld. He further reminded the youth for their civic responsibilities as stipulated under Article 59 of the Constitution.
The value of the power of your vote, you are misusing it. You are putting it on a market stall for sale. That should not happen. Therefore, I'm glad the youth are raising these issues. They have noticed them. These are our children. They have noticed the incidences of bribery in our elections and violence. And we think that by discussing these issues with the youth, we are addressing the right groups, because they are the people who are going to be the future leaders, the future candidates.